Steve Bannon, as we all know, was found guilty last week on 2 misdemeanor counts of contempt of Congress, and he will be sentenced in a few months and could be heading off to prison for an unspecified amount of time. We have to wait till that October sentencing date to find out what exactly is going to happen to him. But in the meantime, now that the trial's over, Steve Bannon's acting like nothing's happened. He's going on with business as usual. And business as usual for Bannon is, of course, trying to overthrow the government of the United States, apparently. On his show yesterday, Monday, Steve Bannon hosted former Trump advisor Steve Cortez, where the two of them had this exchange with regard to that massive Axios report from the weekend that showed that Trump advisors, former Trump advisors and Trump allies are trying to get the former president, if he gets back into office, to be able to fire 50,000 DOJ workers and replace them with Trump loyalists. So Bannon and Cortez had this exchange. Started with Bannon saying, you have to deconstruct it. You have to take it apart brick by brick. Cortez chimes in. It gets my deplorable blood going on a Monday morning to hear Jonathan Swan talk about a purge. A purge of the administrative state. Of course he means that to be an expose, to be a hit on our movement. We took it exactly the opposite and wear it as a badge of honor. To which Bannon said, we're going to have a one-hour special on the Jonathan Swan Axios article. I want everybody to understand deeply exactly what we're doing here, okay? Because you're going to be part of it. And particularly want people stepping forward say, hey, I want to be one of those 4,000 shock troops or there's going to be lots of other opportunities. This is taking on and defeating and deconstructing the administrative state. Now, the administrative state is essentially the government of the United States. Let's be real clear about that, Steves, because that's what's happening here. You want Donald Trump to be able to go into the DOJ, fire up to 50,000 people, and replace them with only Trump loyalists. And folks, there can only be one reason why Donald Trump would want the DOJ packed full of his political loyalists. And it's because he wants to weaponize that agency and go against his political enemies. He wants prosecutions. He wants everybody to be held accountable. And he knows he can't get that if he only has a few thousand appointees running the DOJ. He needs about 50,000 to go after people on trumped up charges and throw them all in jail. That's what this is about. That is what Bannon wants. And again, we're not talking about people with careers in law enforcement or careers in the legal field. We're talking about Bannon's shock troops. Those are the people that just listen to Steve Bannon on a daily basis. They know nothing about how politics actually works. They know nothing of the law. But those are the kinds of people that Donald Trump and Steve Bannon, of course, would put into the DOJ. And they'd go after you. They'd go after me. They'd go after anybody who they believe is a political threat or an honest, you know, a person fighting against him. And those people could, in fact, end up locked up for one reason or another. That's what this is all about. And that is one of the biggest reasons why Donald Trump could never and should never be allowed even anywhere near that White House ever again. And Bannon, basically by his own admission now, is apparently the mastermind pulling the strings on this whole operation.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.